Welcome. Oh my fucking God. I'm here to talk to y'all today about what's been going on in the world today. The world. Let me take a fucking drink. Wait a minute. It wasn't much in that. Let me take a drink of the beer. Because the shit I'm here to talk to y'all about is fucking amazing. I don't know if y'all know what I know, but I know what I know, and I'm finna let y'all know what the fuck I know, because what I know is amazing. I don't know if y'all have been watching, ladies and gentlemen, but the great Jeffrey Williams, aka Young Thug, is on trial. When y'all hear trial, I know it's a bad thing. You know, we don't really want to focus on trials and shit like that, but it happens. We're black in America and we trying to figure this thing out, and sometimes we gotta do what we gotta do, but I don't want to talk about that. This week in the trial is the greatest bit of entertainment that we've done seen in a long... Wait a minute. Are y'all listening to me? Are y'all... There's a young man on the stand by the name of Mr. Kenneth Copeland. I might have the first name wrong, but I know the last name. It's fucking Copeland. If y'all haven't been here to see it, guess what? We're finna bring y'all into the courtroom today. You're going to witness what we've been witnessing for the past, how many days? It's been about two, three days.
This week.
This week
has been
amazing. What day is it? I don't know.
It's the week of Father's Day.
Father's Day, my kids hate me, but that don't matter today. That's another thing. Right now, we're talking about the great Jeffrey Williams and the trials and tribulations of his lifestyle. Turn up the volume for me right now. We missed it.
I was already switching to the lyrics. We gotta hear Young Thug right. on this, man.
That's
we gotta
all right. hear. We can run it back. We can.
We gotta
run
hear
it
this
back.
Nigga Thug, man. He gotta speak his lifestyle.
You gotta pick because
10 years ago, this came out 10 years ago.
10 years ago,
2014.
I don't know if it's unfortunate. I know I'm gonna call it unfortunate because unfortunately, his lifestyle has his ass in the predicament that he's in. Yeah. What they know? What they say? What the thing they say now? When they be like, they don't want to say that.
Free him till it's backwards?
No, no.
Oh.
When they don't want to say like, what they say, never mind. Listen. We've been watching this trial now for the past 8 months. Maybe 7 or 8 months. I don't really know right off the top of my head, but I think it's about 8 months. I might be wrong, but never mind. We've had highs and lows in the midst of this trial, but this week, ladies and gentlemen, is the greatest TV we've been watching in a long time. Sister OJ, Sister Juice,
rest in peace.
Sister Juice, Sis Matlock, Sis, what else? CSI. No,
I ain't never watched none of them. Like, oh, I watched this.
I'm definitely watching this shit.
Tell the people what we're here to do today.
We're here to bring y'all into this courtroom.
We finna bring y'all up to date. We are nigga correspondent.
Well, I don't know if it's quite up to date.
Well, we finna laugh at some shit.
We're finna
bring you the highlights of the trial.
Of this week. And, you know, and I'm gonna tell y'all this. We're not gonna react, because if y'all don't know, y'all here on a lot of reactions. Even though I brought that in late, that should have been earlier, but we're here. We're going to react to this week because it's great television, people. It's great television.
Amazing television.
We've seen disrespect to a judge. We've seen by the prosecution's witness. I don't know if this guy's smart or dumb or smart. Which one is he? I don't know. I don't know if he's doing a great job or a bad job.
Well, he was admittedly in GED classes.
So. He did say he took, no, that nigga said special ed. He took special ed class.
Oh.
He's a different type of. Why would you put. Nevertheless, we've seen lawyers turn into thugs. Have you ever seen. Can I ask you something, Pender Hughes? I'm talking to the great Pender Hughes, if y'all don't know.
Producer Pender Hughes. I love alliteration.
Have you ever seen a thug? No, I said that wrong. Have you ever seen a lawyer turn into a thug in the middle of a trial?
I have, but not on this high of a thing. I saw one where the lawyer asked the judge if he wanted to step outside, and the judge said yes.
You saw that?
Yeah. They didn't. You know, the cameras was in the courtroom.
Were they black?
No, he was white, and I don't think you could see the judge. It was like a low trial, one of them like super local trials or whatever.
The lawyer asked the judge to?
He said, I've been feeling like they're gonna make me look up that clip, but he was no, like, no. But he was like,
we gonna bring y'all that at a later date.
I feel like it's a lot of heat or animosity coming from you, and man to man, if you want to step outside, something. And the judge was like, yeah, I ain't got no problem with that.
The lawyer, the judge.
And then they took a recess.
We going to bring y'all that one day, but not this day. This day is about the great, who? Young Thug Jeffrey. And Kenneth Bartholomew. Why do I give everybody middle name? Why they middle name always Bartholomew?
Because you want yours to be.
This is about them. I bet you ain't never seen a judge decide to go to jail with his client.
I bet you never seen a trial like this ever.
No, I haven't. Have you ever seen a lawyer decide to go to... You know what? I'm going to say that before a later time, too.
Which clip you want to play for? I know. Why you think of a clip you want to play first? Nigga,
you can pick a clip. They all the same piece of entertainment right now. We gonna see what we see with... Who we watching it with? We gonna watch this with y'all. Even though we know what we playing, we don't know the order in which we playing them in. So we gonna be just as surprised as you guys are. But we're finna experience this. Is this a debacle? Is this a debacle?
This first clip is from a few weeks ago. It's not this week, but it's just kind of setting the tone of how crazy this trial is and letting you know that it's been a lot of shit happening. So for this trial, this is someone hacked into the Young Thug trial courtroom Zoom feed.
Wait. Somebody hacked?
Yeah.
I didn't even know that was... Well, I know there's hackers,
but... They use the word hack loosely. It's like somebody that wasn't supposed to be in the Zoom got in the Zoom. So, okay. How they got in the Zoom is, you know... Whatever it is, but I want to show what happened when they got in the Zoom.
Okay, let's watch this, y'all. Y'all look with us.
So this is what happened when they got in the Zoom.
What happened?
Free fuck, mistrial. Free fuck, mistrial.
That happened in real time?
Yeah. Free fuck, mistrial. Free fuck, mistrial.
Wait, whoa. We don't see the reaction of the people that's in the...
You look at this guy right here.
All
right,
let me focus on that guy right there.
All right.
Free fuck, mistrial. Free fuck, mistrial.
It's like people are... I don't even know what the Zoom call was for. I don't know if it was a witness. I don't know what they were doing.
Did they comment? Did the people in that room comment on that after that? Did they speak about what just happened?
No, I think they gave him a recess. You know how they do. They'd be like, you know, we're gonna take a break.
I didn't even know that was possible. How do you
free fuck, mistrial, free fuck.
He keep going.
And he was like Ethiopian or something. That nigga wasn't even American.
No, but that was so that just sets the tone of how crazy this trial is.
Yeah,
that was before they put you know, Fannie Willis. That's who running this whole trial.
Fannie,
the one. Yeah, she's the DA. She's the DA for this trial and the Trump trial.
I haven't seen her.
She remember she was on trial. They were trying to get her recused from the Trump trial.
But she hasn't been here.
No, she hasn't. She's not physically she's a part of that case. She's not a part of this case. She just brought the charges, and then her office, they have lawyers in her office.
Okay. Listen, nevertheless, ladies and gentlemen, what we're talking about is the great Jeffrey Williams and the entertainment. I don't know what to call it. Is it a debacle? Is it entertainment? Is this man really fighting for his life or no? Because I've been nothing but entertained.
I think both can be true.
Okay. Well, listen. The one thing I hope is this shit don't go off no time soon, because I swear it helps me drive every day.
It gets you through the day?
It gets me through the day.
Whole courtroom, 8 hours of...
I don't know. Like, especially this week with Mr. Copeland on there.
Where you watching to get your information from? Like, where you watch the feed from?
I don't know. I just, when I see him and it says live, I click it. That's what I do. And then when I click it,
you're satisfied.
It's the greatest entertainment I've ever seen since I've watched the A Lot podcast.
Nice. This is my man pleading the fifth. And I want y'all to...
If y'all don't know, I damn near spit my drink up right on y'all. I damn near spit it up on y'all, but I caught myself.
This is him pleading the fifth. And just listen to him plead.
Oh my God, Mr. Copeland.
Oh shit.
Listen, this is the greatest entertainer since Michael Jackson.
Okay. How old are you?
Grown.
Okay, what does grown mean?
I'm an adult.
Okay. And when you say you're an adult, what number in years are you?
Watch this.
I plead the fifth.
We can't make this up, ladies and gentlemen. The man pled the fifth on his age. Listen, Pender Hughes, that's not even something you plead the fifth on.
It could be incriminating.
How old you are?
If you touch the kids or something, like, he'd be like, was the girl you touched was 13. How old are you? I plead the fifth.
He has immunity. He can't go to jail for anything he says in this courtroom.
Did they tell him?
Out of all the questions he could have pled the fifth on, he pled the fifth on how old he was.
Yeah, he did.
Was that ignorance? Or entertainment?
Entertaining ignorance.
That's why his name is Pender Hughes, y'all.
That shit is. That's willful ignorance, and
oh,
it's all
my fucking God.
Willful ignorance is always entertaining.
Listen,
when an old motherfucker you know the answer, be like, "Hey, so what you been doing all day, huh?" Or they be like, "Yes."
No. Be like, is the sun out?
Yeah.
I plead the fifth.
Wait a minute. What?
What? Are we in the courtroom? I plead the fifth.
I don't know what you finna ask. The next question could incriminate me.
What's the courtroom? I mean, come on, y'all. Listen, but this shit has been going on all week. This is just the beginning, ladies and gentlemen. This is not, listen, he played the introduction. So imagine what the rest of the trial is going to be like when we bring it to y'all. Because I promise to God, we're going to bring y'all sections of this trial during the course of the course. What do we got next? You can just pick something, because it's all going to be the same thing. I promise to God, we don't even need to know what we pick.
All right. So next up is same guy.
Yeah, of course it is.
No, his name is Copeland, but his street name is YSL Woody. So
YSL Woody.
So just call him Woody. This is
his
Woody.
Name should be up in lights, and he should have a star.
That boy going
on the Hollywood Walk of Fame.
That boy is a star.
Because this guy's a star.
Here we go. This is I just let y'all watch the clip.
YSL Woody. The great YSL Woody, ladies and gentlemen.
So you wish to represent yourself in these particular, in terms of any issues? Sir, Mr. Copeland, is it your desire to release your counsel at this point in time?
She fired.
Wait a second.
She fired?
Wait, hold on.
So do you wish to represent yourself in these particular...
Did he say she fired?
Any issues...
I'll let you listen again.
Sir, Mr. Copeland, is it your desire to release your counsel at this point in time?
She fired.
She fired.
She fired? Okay. So do you wish to represent yourself in these particular, in terms of...
Ladies and gentlemen. Issues? What I want y'all to know and what I want y'all to always keep on the forefront of your minds is he has immunity.
Why is that such a big deal for you?
Because there's nothing he can say that can get him locked up, that can take away his freedom, that can have him in any... Wait, I gotta put a caveat to that. There's nothing he can say legally that can have him in a peculiar situation where his freedom has been compromised. On the streets is a different story.
And I don't think he believed that.
He don't... Well, you know what, ladies and gentlemen? We're going to show y'all where the judge told him there's nothing he can say that will get him... Like, he basically told him, you have to testify because... You've been given immunity. There's nothing you can say that could get you locked up. And you agreed to this at some point. Now that you don't... Listen, by no means am I telling him to testify. He shouldn't even been in the position to where he have to be at this point. As far as I'm concerned. You know, he decided at some point in time during the course of the states building this case to say that he would cooperate. So by no means am I saying he should testify, but he told them people he would.
Why do you think he would do that? Why do you think he would cooperate up until the point he gets on the stand and then not cooperate?
Well, duh. When they told that nigga he had cuffs on his hands when they even approached him with the question. And just so happened they have the videotape of them, of him telling them the answer to every question they're asking him right now.
Yeah, he don't know that though.
Well, he did take special ed classes.
He don't know how this shit works, man. He don't know how this shit works, brother.
Well, you know, according to Woody, he has an extensive record. So he's been in court a number of times.
And probably never took the stand. Like, nigga, I've been in court a number of times, too.
You know what?
Taking the stand is totally different.
That's why your name is Pender Hughes.
Getting that shit on TV. Like, your mama calling you, being like, you need to cut your hair.
You're exactly right. That shit is different. Listen, where we going next? Let's show these great people the next. What is this? Is this a saga? The saga of... Is this a saga?
It is. It's a Young Thug saga.
Or is it a Woody saga?
Pause.
Wait.
You did it. You said it.
Is it a Copeland saga or a Young Thug saga? The saga of... YSL.
Whoever they sell the story to, they both can. Here's the thing. He got immunity, so I would like to see his TV rights and book rights deal.
If this nigga gets a check out of this...
He got to, because he got immunity.
That's the true definition of the American way. The true definition. This is the YSL saga, and what we're watching right now is the ode of Mr. Copeland. Did I use that right?
Who you want to do it, Spike Lee? Yeah, you don't know directors like that.
I do. No, it got to be that nigga that did Black Panther.
Wait, which Black Panther? Black? Oh, the Marvel Black Panther.
Yeah.
Antoine
No,
I forgot. It's I know the nigga. It's another nigga.
One of the black niggas.
The newest nigga. I can't think of his name.
We can't pick the broad.
Why?
Lena Hathaway, because she's going to have some gay shit in there somewhere. She's going to put some gay shit in there.
I mean, he wore a dress on his first album.
Who?
You say he put a gun in his purse.
He wore a fucking dress, man. But listen, ladies and gentlemen, what we're trying to say right now is, if y'all not watching what we watching in real time this week on this trial, you guys are missing the most entertaining shit since Mike Tyson got knocked out by Buster Douglas.
Look how he looking. All right. So
he look like he finna tell a lie right now. Look at his face.
This is him
after he's been held in contempt because he pled the fifth. And it's illegal to plead the fifth when you've been given immunity.
You see, every time, every clip I play, he in a different outfit. So this is a different day.
It's a different day. It's definitely a different day.
All right, so let's see what he said this day.
Wait a second before you play it. Can I give a guess?
I
give a caveat to this? He's been sitting in jail the whole weekend.
Weekend, nigga? He's been sitting for 3-4 years.
No, he's been free. But the minute he pled the fifth Friday, they held him in contempt.
I thought that was the lawyer.
No.
Copeland?
They held Copeland in contempt of court.
For pleading the fifth on his age?
Yes, you can't plead the fifth. If you're the prosecution's witness, you can't plead the fifth. If I gave you immunity, you won't get locked up for nothing you say. You've agreed to testify for me, and now you get on the stand and say, fuck you, I'm not going to do it.
Then we locking your ass up.
I have to. And the judge explained this to him 50-11 times.
That 90
like yin yang them.
All right. What do you? That's that special ed shit. All right.
No.
You took special ed? Why you defending special ed?
I had to call a class. But this has nothing to do with special ed. All this has to do with, I can't be a snitch in the streets. I have to live after this trial. I am a blood. I am Woody. He has a name. He's not a nobody. I can't get on this stand. And every person that prosecution has brought to the stand that wasn't a police officer has taken the same, just not as ignorant as he has. No, I'm not going to call it ignorant because I'm entertained by it. As not as entertaining as Mr. Woody. Go ahead, press play. Let's see what we got.
Today.
Well, I got a vehicle problem.
Oh, my God.
And you see Shannon in the courtroom today.
Well, I got a vehicle problem. Okay. I can't see that far.
All right, so if you want to stand up and look around the courtroom, and look around the entire courtroom. Tell me if you see Shannon in the courtroom today.
Wait a second. Hello. Oh, my God.
Hello. You said hello. What'd you want hello for?
This nigga looked at the jury first. Listen. I don't care who wrote it. You can't write this in a movie. Like, this type of the first place this young wait a second. Hold on, ladies and gentlemen.
Let me go back for the audience.
If y'all watching what I'm watching, the jury is sitting to the left of Mr.
Cole. He almost smiling a little bit.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Should I paint a picture for them before we press play again?
Yeah, because I'm starting over.
Listen. What y'all don't know is all of the people that's on this RICO case is sitting to the left of Mr. Copeland. All the defendants.
Okay.
To the right of Mr. Copeland is all of the jury. The people that's there to vote. Is vote the right word? Is vote the right word?
No, to juror. To be a juror.
But they got to cast a vote.
Yeah, okay. All right.
To vote on the outcome of this case is sitting to the right.
Okay.
When they asked him the question, what was the question? Can you just play the question again and then pause it for me one time? I just want to paint a picture with him. Just play.
And do you see Shannon in the courtroom today?
Pause. They asked this brilliant young thespian of a man if he sees a person that's part of the, what it's called again?
RICO.
That's part of the RICO in the courtroom. He stands up and do what? Mind you, remember what I've told you about who's sitting where, ladies and gentlemen. Let's press play.
Well, I got a vision problem. Okay. I can't see that far.
Wait a second. I don't know what type, if it's nearsighted or farsighted. If you can't see, you're in the room. I don't know. I mean, I've been in courtrooms that they're spacious, but not big enough to wear, like, you have to wear bifocals to not see. To not see who's sitting in this fucking room. He has vision problems. Let's see. Let's go.
All right. So if you want to stand up and look around the courtroom and look around the entire courtroom, tell me if you see Shannon in the courtroom today.
Entire courtroom, ladies and gentlemen. Pause. You know what? I take it back. He did look to his left first. He did look to his left first. But watch how long he looked to his right. Ladies and gentlemen, that's the jury.
What's it?
He looks at the person he looks at.
Do you need to sit down?
What just happened?
Right here, they ain't had any drink.
What? Whoa. Wait, what? The nigga been standing up 40 seconds?
What's it?
You need to sit down?
Nah, I can right here. They ain't had any drink.
Okay, do you want some water?
You gonna give me a drink?
I'll get some water.
Don't drink water.
Wait, ladies and gentlemen. Wait a minute. Did this nigga just ask us for some lean on the low? Wait a second.
You said that. He did.
Listen.
He asked for. He. Wait.
Do you need to sit down?
Nah, I can right here. They ain't had any drink.
Okay, do you want some water?
You gonna give me a drink?
Oh. I get some water.
I don't drink water.
Well, I don't have nothing else for you. But
Listen, I told y'all. Listen, you can't write this. You can't write this, ladies and gentlemen. What we just saw was a man ask the prosecuting lawyer for a sip of lean. In the middle of the great courts of Georgia. It was either lean or Hennessy. I'm taking lean because that's the only thing I heard people of his age demographic refer to as drink.
You're befuddled.
What's going on here?
Court.
Wait, what? What?
So
this shit needs to be on Zeus.
Yeah. You know how niggas in the street be like, man, hey. Man, we holding court 1 o'clock Friday.
Yeah.
That's what he thinks happened. It ain't the same court.
Listen, this nigga heard he got immunity, but what he don't know. Let me tell you what he don't know, ladies and gentlemen. Is his performance on this stand will get his immunity revoked. That's what I'm gonna attribute to special ed. He didn't think this through.
He wouldn't be on. I think that applies to anybody that's on the stand.
You mean not thinking it through?
Yeah. If you end up on the stand, you didn't think something through.
You know what? That's why you're Penderhughes. You're absolutely right. This guy didn't think this thing through.
If he didn't think the crime through, what makes you think he think the defense through?
Ladies and gentlemen, they believe this person is going to be on the stand for about 7 to 10 days. We're on day 3. So imagine the things we have to show y'all. upcoming.
Yeah.
I could listen. Can we get some Young Thug in the middle of this? Can we get a piece of Young Thug in the middle? Because I want y'all to understand what we understand, that what we're watching right now, this is not cinema though, right, Penny Hughes? It's not cinema.
Reality TV. This is real reality TV. Not scripted reality.
It's not scripted, but it's...
You know how they be doing that scripted reality?
Yeah.
It's like, we're going to give you these lines, and then whatever happens off these lines, that's reality.
Mm.
But we're going to put you in this setting with all these drinks, and we know you got a beef with this person.
You got to kick it off, because we're setting the stage.
Yeah, we're setting the stage. Now, that's reality when the stage is set. But this ain't no, you don't
Who's
know what's
going setting the stage happen. In this is...
This reality. That's what I'm saying. This is a different...
Can I ask you a question, though, that we can't play? It's just me and you. Me and you, Pender Hughes. You're pretty smart. You're probably a little more astute than me, but I'm... Listen, I'm the smartest nigga in this room right now, ladies.
But I'm the alpha.
That's another subject. Let's listen. That's another fucking subject. It's not what we're talking about right now. Listen. Listen. What's happening right now? Like,
2024.
No. What's happening? I'm meaning in this trial.
That's what I'm saying. I blame Cat Williams. Everything that happens in 2024, I blame Cat Williams.
Is he trying to help Mr. Williams?
See, and that could be a thing. That could have happened where to the point where he wasn't, and then he was, right?
Mm.
Like, Thug could have got it to him, right? Like, it could have been something like, man, I ain't fucking with that nigga. Yeah, I work with y'all. And then Thug people, for whatever reason, you know, presented or the streets, whatever it is.
Yeah, yeah,
whatever
yeah.
it is makes you be like, nah, now I'm working with him. Because a lot of people, I'm not going to say have flipped, but the support for Thug has... He's garnered way more support now than he did when he first went to jail. And it's a testament to anybody that tell you to jail, that that's been to jail, that it's usually the other way. You have a lot of support when you go in, and the longer you in, the support
wanes. Yeah, yeah.
So when you're in and you get support, the longer you in, you gain support, you feel people are informed.
And let me tell you guys, that's abroad. That don't have to deal with the trials of tribulations of being a black man in America. Sometimes we take the stance of, regardless of what the man did, and I'm not questioning whether it's right or wrong right now at this moment. I'm just telling you our mindset. Sometimes we take the stance of whether what he did or said person did was right or wrong, we just want to see some success fall in our favor sometimes.
A la OJ.
So sometimes we lose track of the cause, and we want to see retribution. Am I using retribution?
It's literally losing track of right and wrong. You know what I'm saying?
It's
you would rather see this person win, despite the rules.
Yeah.
Or whatever it is. And that's happening more now.
Yeah. So allegedly, because that's the word I was looking for earlier too. Allegedly. Because everything is alleged. We don't know whether this guy is guilty, and I'm speaking about the great Jeffrey Williams. We don't know whether he's guilty or innocent of any of the charges that's brought against him. And we don't know if Mr. Copeland is helping him or hurting him at this moment. I'm going to say he's kind of helping him.
Because he's helping your entertainment.
And he's all over the place. And you can't take his testimony as fact. In no way, shape, or form. Do you agree?
Yes.
Can't take it as fact. He's all over the place. He's not concise. You can tell by his demeanor that he doesn't want to be there. Right? Or maybe he does. Because from what Pender Hughes put out earlier, he might be trying to get a contract somewhere else. Yeah. This guy's vying for a TV show.
If I'm a producer, which I am. and I'm trying to start anything like Zeus or anybody, like, I'm gonna give him a contract. And he need money. That's like Tupac fresh out of jail.
We need to see the rest of you. Do we have anything else? I'm wondering if we got any. I mean, ladies and gentlemen, there's a lot of shit to go on in this trial. We've been in this trial right now for 3 days, and I've seen a number of things that we will bring out to you periodically, and along the lines of a lot of reactions. You will see these things come out. We've only taken a few. We didn't take a lot. We only taken a few, but we're going to share them with you right now today, because we're watching the greatest television that we've seen in a while.
I got another reaction. This is a long one. This is probably the most entertaining content if appreciated properly.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Mr. Copeland said, and you haven't answered my question yet.
I'm not going to answer that question.
You're not?
No, I will not answer that
question. Why will you not answer that question?
Because I want to make sure that what I say is accurate, and I'm not trying to get anybody else.
I'm asking you, how did you get this information?
I'm not telling the court. What I'm saying is based upon information.
Okay, well, listen, if you don't tell me how you got this information, then you and I are going to have some problems.
We can have this. I have problems right now.
Okay, I don't want to know about your problems, okay, at this point in time. All I'm asking you at this point in time is, how did you come upon this information? Look, if the case gets reviewed, the record's going to be available for our appellate court, and for whatever reason. But it's disturbing that somehow you have surreptitiously gotten information in regards to the court's private ex parte conversation with a party. I mean,
a witness who was sworn in Friday. The court's telling, this is what I was told. If this is not true. This court handed Mr. Copeland.
Tell me how you got the information.
Listen, whatever you want to do.
Tell me how you got the information, then we can go ahead and go forward.
I'm not going to say that. What I'm going to say is this. I was told, and I hope this concerns the court.
It concerns me that you have proprietary information.
Why is it proprietary?
Or information that you should not be having that was ex parte.
Why?
With a party.
Why?
State of Georgia.
How about the witness? How about Mr. Copeland, who supposedly announced he's not testifying, and he'll sit for 2 years, and then supposedly that's the dishonorable court.
And I'm only quiet so you guys can take all of this in right now.
Supposedly said, I can hold you until the end of this trial. Ms. Hilton supposedly said, actually, all.
Because I'm going to tell you what we're seeing right now.
26 people are disposed of. If that's true, what this is coercion, witness intimidation, ex parte communications that we have a constitutional right to be present for. So I understand that you're upset towards me, but I don't know what I did.
Mr. Steele, how did you come upon this information? Who told you?
What I want to know is, why wasn't I there? Why,
sir, I'm going to hold you in contempt if you don't tell me who this. Tell me who this information was coming from.
I don't want to be held in contempt. Well, I'm not answering that question. That's attorney-client privilege information. I am not
attorney-client privilege.
That's right, Mr.
Unless you were in my chambers, that's the only way you can figure out.
I am telling you.
I tell you what, I'm going to give you 5 minutes. If you don't tell me,
you don't
who
have
you,
to.
I'm you give me 30 minutes.
Who it is? I'm going to put you. I'm going to put you in contempt because that is not attorney-client privilege.
Attorney work product privilege. I am not.
How did you get that information supposedly from my chambers?
He didn't say he was lying.
I'm not. You should have told me.
You should have told me.
You got 5 minutes. Well, you know, I don't need it.
I don't need it.
This is what I was told. Mr. Copeland made statements that he admitted to killing Donovan Thomas.
The greatest lawyer on earth, ladies and gentlemen, what you see right now. Give me a pause. Give me a fucking pause. What y'all just saw was the greatest lawyer since Johnny Cochran. Can I get some thug in my ear? Can I get some thug in my ear one time? Listen.
Why do you say that, though?
Listen. What y'all just saw, ladies and gentlemen, is a lawyer turn into a street nigga, but remain a lawyer. He remained a lawyer. He didn't give up his... The street nigga in him is he didn't give up his source, which is the shit Mr. Copeland and them should have done way back a long ago. Way old ago. He should have done it. He didn't give up his source. He stood on it. He faced contempt. And if y'all don't know what contempt of court is, contempt of court is when the court decides to take you into custody. My lifestyle. Into custody. This man is a lawyer, ladies and gentlemen. He looked the judge in his face and said, fuck you and the great state Georgia, court of Georgia, Atlanta. I'm not telling you shit. I don't need your funky ass 5 minutes. I don't need them. I don't want them. What Mike Singletary said that day, I can't coach.
Don't need him. Can't coach him. Don't want him.
I don't need him.
Don't want him.
I don't want it. I don't need it. You can take all the time you fucking need. I'm not giving it to you. What's going to happen with this lawyer right now is what y'all don't know is every nigga in the state of Atlanta is going to lead this is going to want this lawyer to represent them. Do you agree?
Yeah.
Do y'all agree?
I think he definitely is. He's got his profile up.
Cause he done did some fly shit. And listen, we gonna leave y'all with that shit right there. Cause listen, it's not the end. It's the beginning. It's not the end. It's the beginning. And we gonna bring y'all the rest of this shit during the course of this shit. Wait, is that a lot of shit or is that constant shit?
Yeah,
constant shit. We gonna bring it to y'all. Y'all just stay tuned. Give me some thug. Chanel and these bitches can't see me. I'm in a whole nother league. I ain't got AIDS, but I swear to God I'ma bleed. Till I die. 28 flows up, I feel like I can FLYE. P on top of these bitches. God told me they can never stop me, so they ain't gon' stop me. I'm in that carpet with baby mommy, get sloppy toppy. I'm bleeding red like a devil. I see these bitches plotting. They wanna know I got hymns and I didn't finish college. Yeah. Go. Did a lot of shit just to live this lifestyle. Can't skate from bottom to the top. My lifestyle.